This is Gaston. You probably know him as the boorish and narcissistic antagonist from Disney's Beauty and the Beast. But what if, like the servants in the Beast Castle, Gaston was magically transformed into an object? Namely, a dessert. What dessert would he be and how would we make it? Today, we're going to find out.
So I had an idea for a new video series.
Okay.
Let's make desserts out of famous characters. So what if your favorite character or villain or whatever it is was a dessert? To work this out, I put the names of some famous Disney villains in a hat. You're gonna draw a name, and then I have to come up with a dessert that represents them.
Okay, I like it.
So,
we got Gaston!
Oh, goodness. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. He's French,
okay,
so it has to be a French dessert, mm-hmm. All right? You know, it needs a lot of eggs. He's a really big fan of eggs, from what I remember. He's kind of pompous.
Getting like souffle vibes.
Souffle! Souffle! It's perfect. So yeah, it needs to be a souffle because, you know, just like Gaston, needs lots of eggs to help it get large, and it's fragile, just like his masculinity, so it works out.
He tries to come off like a total Giga Chad, but...
We all know the truth.
So you got quite the array of stuff on that table.
Yes.
So how are you gonna go about making this? I've never seen a souffle be made.
I have not either, but thanks to our friends at Tasty, not sponsored, I watched their video and I think I understand a little bit of how I'm gonna do this. First of all, since this has to be very large, because Gaston eats dozens of eggs a day, we need a huge cooking vessel. So you have the yolk base on one side and then you whip the egg whites on the other, and at the end you combine them together. Hopefully it will rise and become impressive. My biggest fear and why I've never made a souffle is it falling. However, in this particular instance, it's very appropriate if it falls because that's what happens to Gaston anyway.
All right, should be a fun adventure.
Yeah.
So how many eggs we got going in there?
We're gonna do a dozen, which is a pretty large souffle. I mean, if I was being completely accurate, it'd have to be at least 5 dozen, but there isn't a pan around that would possibly fit a souffle that size, nor an oven. So yeah, we're gonna have to settle for half the size of a barge. It does not want to be part of this. Oh goodness, made a mess of that one. That's it.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle.
So this is gonna form the base of the flavoring. We'll put some chocolate in this once it's warm enough and see what I come up with. Heavy cream. Here we go. This is how you could make a really, really nice hot chocolate.
Definitely, yeah, it'll be delicious.
So the next step is going to be the egg yolk base. It's all goopy. Then we're going to need some sugar. Vanilla. Some salt. And some flour. Okay, that's looking pretty good.
Yeah, it looks good.
Next, I'm just going to add this to the chocolate.
What's your confidence level going into this?
Low.
Scale of 1 to 10.
Oh, probably about a 5. But you know what? It's okay. I'm a home baker. I'm reasonably good at it, but I am not classically trained. So things like souffles are not something I get to make on a regular basis.
Wow, I'm a believer.
Oh, thank you.
You're a little full.
She is a little full. So I've got this back on the stove, trying to get it to thicken up a little bit. It needs to be incredibly thick like Gaston, so that's what I'm going for. I may have added the egg yolks a little too early, but we'll see.
Seems like it'd be getting a bit thicker.
Yeah, it's doing the thing.
Yeah, it's definitely what it needed.
Yay, I didn't mess up.
So she says.
Hey. Listen, this isn't supposed to be a worse recipe. I'm doing my job to make this good. Just gonna make sure this is smooth. We're using 1 dozen eggs to help this dessert get large. So I need to whip the egg whites until we get some soft peaks, then add some sugar until we have stiff peaks. So we're starting with a little cream of tartar, and just the egg whites. And let's get whipping. I'm gonna plug it in.
Oops.
Oops. Yay. That's some soft peaks. Mm-hmm. So we're just gonna add a little sugar a little bit at a time until we reach stiff peaks.
Okay.
Start with a little bit. Okay. Very nice.
Looks like a cloud.
Mm-hmm. We're ready to put Gaston together. So now we're gonna prepare the pan for cooking. So I've gotta grease it. Some lovely butter that is softened. Traditionally, you coat the inside of the pan with some sugar.
Bigger bowl is required.
Yeah, the biggest bowl. Have you ever had a souffle before?
Never.
Ah, perfect. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now we just fold this in. This is beautiful though. Look at how fluffy. It's getting so fluffy.
It's so fluffy!
I can see how this is delicate when it bakes.
Yeah. No one whips like Gaston, no one drips like Gaston, no one gets on the floor, so I slip like Gaston. And we're ready. Let's just find out.
Let's just go.
Okay. Oh, it might all fit. Wow. Could it be that there's not enough? We're not making more. This is gonna have to do.
This is gonna be an absolute unit of a souffle.
Yeah, it is. From there, I'm just gonna go around the edge with my finger just to separate it so it gets that nice rounded shape.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, sort of did it. It's fine. Okay, oven.
Oven. Good luck, little guy. Not so little guy. Okay.
Okay.
Look at magnificent Gaston, the Giga Chad of the souffle.
It is the Giga Chad souffle, except way less nice than a Giga Chad. You just dig the spoon in and let me know.
Okay.
Let me know what it tastes like.
Oh, I'm like nervous. If I talk too loud, is it gonna collapse?
It might. It's okay. It's okay. If it falls, it's only appropriate.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Ooh.
Look at this beast. Beauty.
All the things it should be. Mm. Beauty and the Beast.
True. I need to do that on purpose.
Or not. Still too hot?
It's still too hot.
Okay. Take your time. Take your time. No rush.
It's cool on the outside, but molten in the middle.
Oh, I can see it's falling a little bit.
Yeah, it's sinking in a little.
Yeah. Deflating like Gaston's ego.
Okay.
Okay, you sure?
No. I'm gonna go for it anyway. Mm. Oh. That's really good.
Is it?
Mm. It's like a very rich brownie.
Mm.
But it's like lighter and fluffier.
Ooh.
I think part of the reason was there's maybe a little too much of this on there.
Yeah, maybe.
And so when I was like trying to eat it in, it was like creating a tornado of powdered sugar in my mouth.
All right. Well, I'm feeling pretty good about this then. Giant souffle, many, many eggs, pulled it off.
Mm-hmm. What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments what you think about this Gaston souffle.
Oh yeah, also let us know if there's any characters you want us to try, if we should keep this going as a series, because it was pretty fun to do, and I think there's some great characters we make into dessert. What do you want to see?
Mukbang of souffle, souffle mukbang up next.
Yeah, that's all for you.